And here's the other thing too, when it comes to determining what's legitimate and what's not, you know, obviously the Bible spells out how to do things. And there are certain doctrines that I'll hold to as this is what's right and this is how you do things. But it doesn't mean that churches couldn't have started in an incorrect way, but still be considered legitimate churches in God's eyes. Right? Just because things weren't done the way, exactly the way that he is going to tell you it has to be, it doesn't necessarily mean that, you know, and obviously we're going to say, no, it needs, you know, things, if we're going to start a church or do anything, we're going to do things according to the Bible. But if you're going to look back into history, you know, you can't just say, well, they just aren't because of whatever, and come up with extra biblical reasons or just using logic to deduce. One of the things that we saw when we went through our list of churches in the book of Revelation was that they had a lot of problems, yet they were still considered to be legitimate churches. I mean, one even had a prophetess, Jezebel, right? That was causing people to commit fornication, real bad problems in the church. And they were still considered a legitimate church in God's eyes. But I mean, you say, but the Bible says I suffer not a woman to teach, but to be in, you know, it's like, yeah, I know, I agree. And that's wrong. But here's a church that had a female preacher, that had a, you know, and they were still considered a legitimate church in God's eyes. I mean, they were. Now they're about to lose their candlestick, but so you get what I'm saying here. We can't be, you got to be able to look at evidence like that and say, let's not be so strict of going back and be like, well, you need to have this perfect pedigree or else God's not even considering you a church. And this also, what a lot of it stems from, and it's why they're called Baptist briders, is their totally incorrect understanding of the marriage sup, you know, the marriage feast of the Lamb and just who the bride of Christ is in Scripture. And what they'll say is that other people can be saved as other believers, but you're not going to be, you know, have your special position if you weren't, you know, baptized by a person who's had the hands laid on by this person, that can trace it back to the apostles, right? That you need to have that, otherwise it's not legitimate, and you need to be in a church that could trace its root, you know, and they're real strict on that type of a thing, and they'll say that, you know, basically it's the we're the only true church mentality, which is another dangerous area to get into when you've got a church that's saying, well, I mean, the Catholic Church, we're the only true church. The Mormons, we're the only true church, right? But you know, you're not going to hear it said here, we're the only true church. Because I don't believe that. Now, the churches that I think teach the closest to what's right and biblical and accurate are going to be independent fundamental Baptist churches. That's what I believe. But it doesn't mean there aren't any other churches out there that are also legitimate churches in God's eyes, teaching good doctrine with saved people in it. Because I don't believe that it's only independent. You know, but you're going to have your best bet finding independent fundamental Baptist churches. And that's been my experience, and that's what I believe. But I don't think that we've got the corner on the truth and being a legitimate church. So when you hear these people saying that, you got to be careful, because that leads you down some very weird doctrinal paths where you have no alternative, because if you're part of the only true church and this is what the only true church is saying, now you've just completely closed off any alternative to well, what, you know, is this right, and challenging what's being said. Well, this is the one true church, so this must be right. And that kind of gives them their own credibility and authority as saying, well, if you can establish, like, this is a classic cult leader type of a move, is convincing people that you are in the one true church, because then you could get away with a lot more. That's a point I'm trying to get across here, is that that's the mentality that follows of just saying, well, we've already proven to you that we are the legitimate right church, because we set up what it takes to be the legitimate true church. We checked all the boxes. So now what we say is true, and what other people say are lies. And you can't use that as your authority. You have to use the Bible as your authority for everything. For everything. And be able to challenge your beliefs, no matter who holds other beliefs, and determine what's true based on what the Bible says, not on what history says, not on what who's saying it says, but what this word says.